Hello, and in this video I'm going to show you how we can get the volume from Houdini into the Niagara particle system. So here in Houdini I created a basic volume, so we have an animation on this where we have smoke going up. So now the idea is here that I want to get this into a game engine, or more specifically the Niagara particle system. There are multiple ways of doing this, like you can render this out in a texture sheet and so on. But what I want to do is I want to use our plugin with Niagara and convert this into a point cache. So with the plugin we can open these point cache files and use them in Niagara particle system. So here where I have imported my pyro fields, we have our animation. So you can also get this file from the link in the description. So it's a basic smoke, and I created a pop network that will convert that smoke into a point cache. So here we have a small setup to do this. So here again, we are going to add points. So here this controls how many points we will have. Then we will use the node that will do the most of the work, which is called pop affected by volume. So we will use this node to let our particles be controlled by a volume. So it's a very important note here. And then again, we can set some colors. So in this case, I'd set some more flame colors. You can easily tweak this to, if you want to have something more magical, like blue or green, you can easily start changing these colors. So you can easily tweak that. So once we have that, this is what the result looks like. So we have just a bunch of points and they are flying in the air. Also notice here that at a certain point I also stop spamming points. So important to know that we don't need to continuously keep spamming new points in the pop network. So once you have to set up this point cloud, we can then use again here our plugin tool. So we can set the frame range, save our file. So in this case, we should give this a proper name. So this will be better. And then also again, make sure you always double check what attributes you want to access. So again, if I want to do something with scale or other attributes, we're going to add those values in here. So I'm quite happy with the results. And only thing to do now is just pressing the render button. So same as before, either use the import feature or drag and drop these files in here. So we have them. And if we double click on them, we can see again what information we have here available. Then let's create our particle. So I'm going to right click here, go to FX and create a Niagara system. So again, you can start an empty one, or you can start here from the Houdini basics. So I'm going to add that and click finish. So I'm going to call it Smoke Houdini and open this. So this is the base setup. We again have to use our own files here. What you could also do here is sort of create a master parameter for this. So we can type in Houdini point cache. And now we basically here have a Houdini main parameter for the point cache. I'll also give this a proper name. So we can add our smoke here, and now these can now be set with our point cache. So if I want to change now a setting here, I can go here to my main point cache and switch that out, so I don't have to do this multiple times. So as you can see, it actually already is working, so that's pretty cool to see. Again, we will have to retime the particle. So if I go to my point cache, we have 4, 1, 2, 5. So we're going to have to readjust here the loop duration. So 5. So that will be better. So this is already working, actually. So we don't have to do that much more. We can make it more nicer by, again, we can use the color. So we can here set color and go home. Go here to advanced, and use our Houdini color. So it should be the more flamey colors. Something interesting here, what we can do is we can, for example, use a sprite sheet. So I already have here a texture with a sprite sheet. So I have a basic sprite sheet with a small smoke cloud. And we can use this also in here, for example. So right now we are just having these dots. But instead of these dots, maybe we want to actually have something that looks like a cloud or a volume. So here I already set up a material. So if I go to my materials, I already have here a material for that. So it's not that complex. We just have our texture sheet here and some more values to tweak it. And also, of course, the particle color, so we can control it from the particle system. So I'm going to replace here my basic material with that smoke instance here that I have. And as you can see, if I take a random frame, we now have that spreadsheet. Now, of course, we don't want the full image there. We only want to have a part of that. So I know that here, if I go to sub-UV, that I have 5x5 images, so I'm gonna have to press 5x5 here. And now I see this very small particles. Important here as well, then if I now play the animation, we can see that there's not really looping over my sprite sheet. So I'm gonna go here to particle update, and I'm gonna add an animation here. So sub-UV animation, and this will then animate that particle and the number of frames. So I have 5 rows and 5 columns, so 25. And that will now work better. Then I also like to change the scale of the sprite. So scale sprite size. And I want to control this by a curve. So let's break this down first to a float and then to a curve. So now I can play around with the values. So I can make this really big here and it goes small, or maybe it goes the other way, like so. Like if you break this really high, this looks really cool. Maybe this is too much. Something else you can do here is also like let the particles rotate. So as you can see here, this is clear to see, they are always the same position. Like we can see the animation going on there, but they're all in the same position. So let's do some sort of a rotation, and we probably have to look for the sprite rotation. So here, and let's just crank that up to see if that will work. So now we have some rotation there. We can also do some random rotation as well. So what we can say is when the particle are spawning, we can add some random rotation here. So we're gonna do random. So random range. Let's say from maybe 0 to 1 might be good enough. But we can play around with that. Maybe we can, let's say 50. Let's go higher in value to get more variation there. And now let's drag that into our scene. So put in the smoke particle. And as again, this is quite flexible to change and find different ways. We also have to be careful with how many particles we're spawning. So the more we spawn, of course, the nicer it will look. You can also switch this to, of course, the GPU simulation, which will be handling more. One of the advantages of this, I would say, that this is actually more in a 3D space. So we can actually turn around with the camera and really get a 3D feeling out of this. Because other ways are more two-dimensional or like camera facing. So here, for example, I have my smoke sprite sheet, and you can see this will always face my camera. So this is just a plane playing that animation, and it's just facing my camera, and it will give the same result over and over again. But with this point cache, what we do is we will have a real 3D information, and we can have different angles and other results. So some more changes I want to do is maybe like control the alpha here in the color. So maybe we can do a curve as well. And then over time, this should then be slowly be fading out. So it's less red at the end. So we can play with this, maybe like this. Also, I can go just back into Houdini and change the color there. So in Houdini, let's say I want, for example, that this darker value should start sooner and this red value should be moving. I can also here play around with that. So it's less of the red value and it will fade out sooner. So it's a flexible way again of working. So I can just render this out. So we just render out the file again. And in here, in the point cache, we can just right click, re-import point cache, and you should have the new information there. So that was it for this video. I showed you how we can use a certain volume from Houdini and convert it to a point cache and bring that into the Niagara system to create some more complex particle. So hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.